I've been an EMT for 10 years. I started volunteering when I was a prison officer in 2006, and the opportunity came for me to be full-time in 2013. So since 2013, I've been full-time.
And you've obviously, I guess, had seen quite a few experiences in that time.
Yes, seen a lot of experiences in my time. And
what kind of things stand out for you?
Stand out mostly is, I think I have two that really stand out above all. The first one would be a gentleman hit a car head on, and he was drinking driving, and he died instantly. And we were not even 2 minutes away, sitting at the rubber tree. And when we got to the scene, he wasn't even bleeding yet, but he was instantly expired. And so that was really...
Is that the first time you've seen somebody who died?
Oh, no. Yeah, I had seen others.
So why was that particularly shocking for you?
That one is because I knew the individuals in the car. That I know them. And that was traumatizing for the first thing. People were taking a lot of pictures. And not even 2 minutes has gone by. That was disturbing. So I had to instruct the police to get these people to start taking pictures while I'm doing my assessment, the mechanism of injury and scene safety and things like that. And then looking at how it happened, trying to figure out, looking at his injuries to see how this all happened. So it was very traumatic.
But how long ago was that?
Maybe about 2 years or a year and a half ago.
That stayed with you?
Oh, definitely.
Quite vividly, obviously.
Yeah, if I drive across the spot, I don't think about it much, but sometimes I do. Every now and then when I drive across the spot, I'm middle road. Bermuda small, you're going to drive, but I think about it. And so that was...
Because people don't appreciate that an EMT might actually not quite have flashbacks. That might be the wrong word, but certainly think about it.
Oh, yeah, you think about it. You definitely think about it. The other one was a young lady had an accident in Campillo. A young preteen, I think about, and that was pretty traumatic.
And that was a road traffic collision?
Yes.
What happened then?
She came off the hill on a pedal bike and didn't see the bar, and she hit one time. So on the way to the call, we just heard a young person in a road traffic accident. And my partner was driving, going ahead. Then dispatch says, step up the call, because the person is having difficulty breathing. Stepping up, and as soon as we got on the scene, the fireman saying there's a load and go. So
load and go is get in the ambulance as quickly as possible.
Get them in the ambulance and go. Split. So at that point, you still didn't know until she's right in front of me, and then you start CPR.
So when you get those kind of messages as you're in the ambulance, what goes through your mind? Are you able to compartmentalize it and be professional? Or?
Oh yeah. Definitely. You look at what you're going to expect. What to expect, what equipment you're going to get out of the back, looking at where I am at emotionally, if I'm solid, if I'm focused, get myself together, communicate with your partner, hey, you all right? How you feeling right now? What's going through your mind? You okay? Yes, I'm okay. And we go over the procedure in our minds and probably say something to each other.
So that's afterwards, when you're at home, does it
problem? Oh, man. And I'm home. In serious cases, I may not sleep for 24 hours. I may not,
So what, are you playing it over in your mind?
Yeah, play it over and over. If I did my 100% best, if I gave it all I've got. Thinking about the family, because right here when the doctor was telling the family, and you don't listen to the screaming or crying and anger and all kinds of stuff going on. So sometimes they pass out, and you gotta help them too. You gotta give them oxygen, help some of them calm down, and just see the actual horror of all of a sudden trauma. So that would keep me awake for about 24 hours. It wouldn't be a restless awake, it would just be a reflection.
Mm.
And then, trauma is not a good thing anyway.
No.
So,
So, unfortunately, we see an awful lot of injuries because of road accidents. I think in October, your boss is a BHB, you said we were in the region of 40 a week. What's your opinion of the driving standards here?
Driving standards, I am Bermuda, are deplorable. One of the hardest things, people are not courteous of other drivers, even in 5 o'clock traffic or 9 o'clock traffic. Everybody's in a hurry to go somewhere, everybody's in a rush, and they're not thinking of the other person. The third lane, riders on your bike. I used to do that. I refuse to get a bike anymore. You ride a bike because of the injuries that I see. I don't want to purchase another bike.
Have you got kids?
Pardon?
Have you got kids?
Yes, I have children.
Are you going to let them ride a bike?
My oldest son has a bike, and I worry about that. And my youngest son is about to go 16, so next year, so it's a concern. Whenever I heard RTC, blackmail, or anything like that, it goes through my mind a little bit. And saying, I hope that's not my son, because it's a possibility.